Now next one is the displacement time graph of an object which is having, suppose the displacement is different for different time. So it is like that. So this type of graph means actually the velocity is changing with time. Okay, that means the velocity is basically non-uniform velocity. And in this particular case, if you want to find out the average velocity, then what we have to do? We have to find out the total displacement by total time. And now in this fifth case, see, if the displacement time graph is continuous curve like this, then the velocity is continuously changing. Okay, so this is also changing, but discrete changing, but this is continuous changing. And in this type of cases, if you want to find out the average velocity, what do you have to do? We have to take any two point and we have to draw two perpendiculars on the time axis and on the displacement axis, and then we have to find out this displacement delta s and this time delta t, and then we can find out the velocity delta s by delta t, that will be the average velocity in between these two points. Okay.